podcast is sponsored by MrExcel. Learn Excel from MrExcel podcast, episode 1259, Better Underlines. Well, hey, welcome back to the MrExcel netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Again, if you have questions for the podcast, send them in, bill@MrExcel.com. Today is not a question. This is just one that I talk about in my seminars all the time. I always hate when managers make people add the tiny little columns between the columns, like this blank column B and the blank column D and the blank column F. And the reason that they generally do that is that they've used the bottom border to underline their headings, and they want a little break between the borders of each column, and they think that looks better. All right, well, this is dangerous because someone's going to sort part of this data and not all of this data. And of course, if you have tried this, if you try and just use the regular underlines, the underlines only fall underneath the words, and it doesn't, make the manager happy. That's not what they're looking for. But today I have a great trick. This trick is from Paul. Paul was in one of my seminars in Las Vegas last spring, and Paul taught me what I think is a beautiful trick. Underneath the underline option up here, we have underline and double underline. I don't want either of those. I want to go into format cell. So I'm going to click the dialog launcher here, or press Control 1. And we get into the format cells dialog box. Now here on the font tab, check this out. Although single and double underline were available, there's two other types, including single accounting and double accounting. Let's check out single accounting. Click OK. And oh, wow. Hey, single accounting underlines almost the entire column, but it doesn't underline the entire column. So there actually then appears to be a break between each of the items. So if you have a manager who's trying to get the breaks between the underscores, don't use the bottom border. Don't insert the blank columns between each column. Just go in and use what they call the accounting underline to solve that problem. Well, there you have it. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast.